About 2 weeks ago, I went to Copenhagen, Denmark to film a series of mini documentaries with an organization called Power to Change. The purpose was to learn more about the Danish culture, plus documents and build relationships with Danish Christians.
So this is our video suite,
Sweet.
and
1 week before the trip, I went to Guelph to
our filming
discuss
trip. So we're
equipment
here.
and
It's not
ideas
packed yet,
with
but
the
pretty sweet.
organizers. We were a team of six and joined a group of university students headed there for campus ministry. We checked our bags in and flew to Iceland for our layover. A very nice man in Iceland refilled our water bottles because the water was way too pricey, and most of us were still carrying Canadian currency. After about 8 hours of flying in total, we landed in Copenhagen, Denmark. We stayed at this hostel called Steel House, and they would provide a very hard cheese bun and coffee in the morning. Patrick took us to meet our first Danish Christian that we were documenting. His name was Hans, and he owned a modern monastery. Hans really believed in community and fellowship, and he would invite strangers to come live with him and his wife. They would pray together in the morning and then eat breakfast together. That's a tight, narrow launch.
Not too bad. The more thing that I'm worried about is just the signal once I go over these reeds.
Oh yeah.
That's
Oh, those
awesome.
birds, those
The second Danish Christian I met was a student, and he goes by the name of Jonas. Jonas gave us a mini tour of Copenhagen and took us to this cool spot called The Wave, where I took cool photos for Instagram. Got done filming at Copenhagen University.
Yeah, bro. Sick filming.
Yeah, bro. It's
Yeah.
sick.
The third Danish Christian was someone quite special and different. He lives in a town called Christiania. It's basically a place where you can buy marijuana openly on the streets, and people are free to do drugs as they please.
I'll turn that camera off now if I will.
This man goes by the name of John, but people in the town call him Little Jesus. John chooses to love in a challenging environment.
Almost can't blame them for trying to get a little sleep there, so.
As we flew back to Canada, there was a lot on my mind. I've always heard stories of Christians displaying love and faith in radical and powerful ways, but seeing it in person was impactful and inspiring. Sometimes I wonder why God has given me a love for filmmaking. What is his purpose for me? I think about that from time to time. but I know the legacy I leave on this earth will be for His glory.
It's a video! Wait, wait, wait.